We are gathered as a group to come and thank God for many things that He has done for us. And we do this every month, at the end of the month, acknowledging that getting to the end is not by our own accord, but by the will of God. We also meet to celebrate birthdays of those who are born in June, because we are not able to meet in June because of the diocesan activities, and those born in July. To thank God for the gift of life. And in our today's reading, the first reading, we hear about Elisha. And there come a man who comes with bread made from the first fruit. And when he comes, Elisha tells him, give it to the people. And he says, it's just a small amount. Why should I give it to the people and they will not eat enough? Then he insists and says, give it to the people. Today, the same way, we as young people, sometimes we are afraid to leave what we are. Tunaogopa kuishi ambacho sisi wenyewe tupo ama tuko. You are afraid to leave your authentic you. And you want to imitate other people because you are afraid, what will people say? The biggest worry of this guy was people will not get enough. Sometimes, even coming to read in front, and we thank those who have read, they have read very well. If you are told to come and read the Word of God, you're afraid. Because you think that people will judge you or will not have enough of you. Whatever you are is a gift from God. And whatever you are as a person is the first fruit that God gave you. Your talent, your ability, kile unachoweza kukifanya, whatever you do in life, that's the gift of God. And you shall not be afraid to give it to people and to others. Do not wish to be so inclined to think of what others will say. No, and that's why I say it. Do not be afraid to be told by people you are showing off. This guy was afraid of showing off what he had, because after people will not have enough, wataanza kumsengenya. Do not be afraid to show off. Furthermore, if you are showing off, it means you have something to show off. If you have nothing to show off, you have nothing to show. So there is absence. When you're using your talent, wakati unatumia talanta yako, ama kipaji ambacho Mungu amekupa, watu watasema unajionyesha. Lakini ni kweli, jionyeshe, ili waweze kushukuru Mungu kuwa amekujalia kipaji ambacho uko nacho. If you're beautiful, do not hide your face so that usikae kama unalinga. Sikae kama unaringa. Watu wengi hawako wameshikanisha, wote ni wa Kikuyu, lakini negai mbele. You know, sometimes we are afraid to do something. You know, they are said, people will say, we have a prophet among ourselves. I want to say this, and I want to say it without fear of contradiction or being misquoted. I am a supporter of Gen Z. Full. Kwa mali na hali. Kainemwega.
kakwera gwatia kwa hali na mali ole kwa hagi hakuna mali kwa hali sina mali sawa matusi ndio umejaliwa.
Why am I supporting them? It's because they have reminded everyone the value of honesty and the value of being just. But as I support them, as I support you, because most of you seated here are Gen Z, apart from the patron and the matron who are, some are even in the lost generation. As I support that clamor, tunapowaunga mkono, nawaunga kwa sababu wanataka haki na ukweli. But I also tell them, and I challenge all of us, because we are in school, and you want truthfulness or integrity and honesty. Are you honest in your exam, or you are one of those who use Mwa Kenya? If you are, you are no different from Zakayo. Hata wewe unafaa kuaguka naye. If you are working somewhere, do you leave your place or workstation unattended and go, and someone comes to where you are supposed to serve them and you do not serve them? You are no different from the thugs. Hata wewe unafaa. Are you that one person in school who the parents have paid money and are struggling out there to make ends meet, but when you go to school, you don't give it your all? Hata wewe, you are no different from Zakayo. Hata wewe, unafaa kuaguka naye. Let us be those people who live like when you do something, do it out of conviction and out of goodwill. When you come to church out of goodwill and from the honesty of your heart. I would prefer to have, I know all of you come because you're not forced. I am so happy when you are actually self-motivated to do this. It's better not to go to church than to be forced by circumstance to go.
Sikue, kuna chalia likam hapa, kwa sababu kuna dem anamezea. Ene mwera. Ama kuna demu amekam kwa sababu kuna mtu anakrashia. Ene mwera. So, na unaona hata wakati wa lunch, anapita tu hapo hako, ili yaone kama, ataonekana. Sijali, omba vizuri kwa kanisa, Mungu atajibu kwa ombi yako.
But let us do everything, kila kitu tunafanya, from the honesty of our hearts, so that we become what we have heard in the gospel. If I may ask, kwa hii injili, kuna miracles ambazo zimetendeka hapa. Even on the one of multiplication, there are other small miracles that have happened. Ya kwanza, ni kupata wanaume 5,000 safari moja. Ni ngumu sana kupata 5,000 men atago. It's very difficult. Ya pili, ni kuambia wanaume wakae kwa nyasi na wanakaa. Wanaume lazima wapewe viti, wamama na watoto. So kuona wanaume wamekaa kwa nyasi, it's another miracle. Another miracle ni kipii. Kikiwa kwa kuchunga, kinakaa na mkate. kihina mugate kuma kiroko nginya tha inyanya gitari kiraria that's a miracle. A boy, a lad, with a bread from morning to three in the evening without eating. Na fish. It was a miracle. No agagia to me to duka. Ingine, na diokupwa sana, tumeabiwa ni wanaume elfu ngapi wameka? Elfu tano. Wamepewa chakula na nini? Arome giri dhano, mahe iruwe ilione. Yani watu wazima walikula chakula ya nini? Ya mtoto. You know, those are the simple miracles in life that we ignore looking at the greater miracle. After they have been sat down, they were fed by a boy. Sometimes you may think you are irrelevant or not important in life. But my friend, you are what your village needs to be saved. Nyinyi mlioka hapa, individually, you are what your family, you are what your village, you are what your country needs to be saved. Wewe, mwenyewe. And people, some of us here can testify that they are working so hard because it's they that their family look up to. Some of us, if we do not work hard, our families will always lack. How watu wangu wana chakula? How many families, if you do not work hard, your mother will remain forever in poverty. Your father will remain forever in poverty. Your brother and sister will always remain forever in poverty. It is you. You are not irrelevant. You are very relevant in this life. And whatever small you have, 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish, that's what God wants to bless you in. Grace builds on nature. Gai aradhimaga kiria wina kio. Gai ni areto radhimaga. Maira maito. Nimo igwa hai hado gai aradhimaga mialio. Aradhimaga wira amo koma ito. Whatever you do, however small, kama unaenda kwa kibarua, work hard. That's where God will bless you. Utatoka hapo na utapa. If you are employed, work and work diligently. That's where God will bless you. Do not feel like you're not important. All of us are important. And this is what I want to tell all of us. Wakati unatembea, wakati umelala na hata kuota, always remember one thing. Do not look at your family. You had no choice where to be born. Kuna mtu alichagua baba yake? Kuna mtu alichagua mama yake? Sini kujikuta ulijikuta? Uko ni kujikuta. But from where you are going forward is your choice. The boy had a choice to give the fish and bread to Jesus or to run away with it. No ikihina uthie ugitia na gigutumitwo nduka kimenya kia neana ni giguthie kuragwo kiumeri. Niki giumeririe na andu acio matingiareire. Likewise, you have a choice to give to God what you have or to run away with it. In this reading, we have also been told that they fed and there were leftovers. Guys, are we charitable to each other? Are we charitable to each other? Wenye tuko hapa, wacha na hawa kwa huko nje, sisi ambao tuko hapa. Are we charitable to each other? Do you feel like I would want to help somebody? Do you have that inner push to want someone else to benefit from your help? Ni uweziria na utaithie mundu ungi. Na utaithio ti wa besha. Utaithio to wa kuhe mundu irio. Utaithio to wa gwikira mundu kiundu. Even a good smile. Tukitoka hapa nje, kuna watu wanajikalishana wakati wa lunch. Shall I note? Kuna watu wanakaa peke yao. Sometimes, tunaweza wajaji, huyo achana naye anapendaka kujikalisha. But have you ever gone to them and smiled to them and told them something good? Uthiongo musmaile. Nino go higure kanu. Gaide mwela. You know, sometimes we ignore people that really need our help. Have you ever seen someone who has gone astray? Just go and tell the men, jenye unapitia CVD. Kitakulama. Acha. That one word, that one sentence is an act of kindness. Ushaiona mtu. You may not have the help to give them, but you can approach as the priest, you can approach a matron or a patron or someone else and seek help on their behalf. Father, uri andirona ngani agithiri ahota kuiita ni ukamwariria vile fulani ako. Father, he needs our help. We need to combine our help. As I conclude, we are a people of God. Na kila tunapokuja, tuna sakramenti ya Ekaristi. When we consecrate the host and the wine and become the body and blood of Jesus, all of us eat from the same altar. Utikoragwo na Ekaristia ya patron na matron. Utikoragwo na Ekaristia ya adhuri na atumia. Hakuna Ekaristi ya vijana. Hakuna Ekaristi ya watu hii. Sisi wote we partake the same Eucharist. Hata Pope angekuwa the same. Bishop akiwa the same. Cardinal the same. Fathers the same. Maskini hapo. President mwenye anapokea hapo. Hakuna siborium inawekwa kando atini ya president. What does it tell us? That in the face of God, sisi wote ni wa maana. Na Mungu anatuchukulia kama watoto wake. Kama vile mama anapika toka chungu moja na anawapa watu wa familia yake yote chakula kutoka pale. We eat from the table of God. We are all one people. Sisi tulivyo hapa. We are one people. Let us love each other. Let us take care of each other. Take care. It doesn't matter how mete Luka or from the other end of Jogwini or wherever we are from. We are one people. That's why we eat from one pot, the altar of our Lord Jesus Christ. When you see anyone here, he is your brother and he is your sister. When one of us is suffering, we are all suffering. When one of us is happy and jubilating, we are all in jubilation. Let us have the heart. I want to insist this. Aki watu wangu, hata mimi, tuangalie roho zetu. Tukue watu wa roho safi. Wherever you are, ningependa sana. Najua hata nyinyi mngependa. Nikienda mahali ambapo unafanya kazi, nikiingia tu hivi, niseme, ah, fulani, ah, huyo ni mwana yudhu wangu. Boss ananiambia, eh, huyo kijana ni roho safi. Aki, hapo ndipo nasemaga, ni mimi, nini atoketie. Hapo tu unaanza. You know, it gives you joy. Ate ai. Na deal na nani. Nikuwa na nani nyini watu roho safi. So anyway, what I mean is that let us have that clean heart. That wherever you go, you illuminate others because you have that clean heart. And if we have a clean heart, we will not be corrupt. Aki tuache corruption. Mimi afadhali ukuje uniambie, Father, nilifuta kazi kwa sababu boss aliniambia niibe, nikakata. What is it? What benefit is there? Umeajiriwa mahali uangalie mtu kia anajenga. Then you see people going away with cement and the material, building material. Na uko hapo. And that person, you see how God don't, why God does not bless us. Imagine, gutwarete handu udorere kia, and all my trust, all my hopes are in you. Then the person I so much trust, the person I so much put a lot of hope in, is the same person stealing from me. You know, when that person come to chase you away, they do not only chase you away from that place. They chase you away with a lot of pain in their heart. Akora wona karuo kange kena hau. Atra hota kwa, unaedaka kumuongelesha na kwambia, eh, acha hiyo story. Yani unaona hataki, yani it's so painful. That person does not tell God anything, but the pain they feel in their heart is an enough prayer for God to punish us. Imagine you are put in a place, in a hospital, or even, for example, the biggest employer wa vibarua hapa ni farm. Sindio, ni yeye or something, the farm's here. Imagine umewekwa procurement, na kwa procurement umekataa kununua safety material, ama safety material zimenunuliwa ukaiba. You know what that means? If those people who go to spray in the farm get sick because of lacking the protective gear, their death is on your head and in your hands. If you are in a hospital and you swindle money because you are the accountant, and people go without drugs, if they die because they lack drugs, if a mother lost their children because of you, the death of that child, the death of that person is on your head. Someone said they want to ask me, what about teachers? Woe unto you if you are a teacher. Or want to be a teacher. Augustine, I'm not on your case. Imagine all the parents in a school. Like, let us give an example of a good school here, St. Monica Monyaka. We have about 21 around there teachers. But the population in that school, the girls, are way about 700. That means the life of 700 children is in the hands of 21 people. And it's not only the life of those children. What are they going to become? They will be the doctors, they will be the lawyers, they will be the nurses, they will be the president, they will be whatever that we need in this country. So, woe unto you, if you are a teacher and all you go to seek for is money. Let me say this and say it categorically here. If you work for money and never put people's life first, I want to use a very bad word, but please forgive me. You are a prostitute. If you work for money, you are a prostitute. Because you don't care about whoever comes. All you need is money. Let us have a clean heart to take care of each other so that we can distribute what we have and each one of us will get enough. Tumsifu Yesu Kristo.